Celebrating CPCA's 20th anniversary gives us an opportunity to reflect back and appreciate all it took to get our organization where it is today. And as I reflect back on all the wonderful staff that we have had at this organization during this time, there is one person who stands out and deserves special recognition for her outstanding contributions to the success of CPCA. And that person is Carole Loeb, who was my executive assistant for over 14 years, from 1998 to 2012. Carole Loeb passed away earlier this year after a brave battle with cancer. All of us at CPCA were greatly saddened by her passing. She was such an integral part of the CPCA family for years and an invaluable colleague to me and many others during her time here. Carole Loeb is the recipient of this year's Hero Award, and I can't think of a more deserving individual, particularly as we mark our 20th anniversary, and again, celebrating and thinking and recognizing and valuing all that it took to get here. Carole was such an exceptional individual. A mother of six and a grandmother, she loved her family more than anything else. I mean, over the years, and we heard about it in the office, she paid so much attention to detail for the family holidays. She was so nurturing and loving toward her children and grandchildren. I'll tell you the truth, sometimes I secretly suspected that the only reason Carole was working was to make sure that she could keep doing special things for her family to make their lives better. Now, Carole dropped out of college when she married and started her family. But during her tenure at CPCA, she actually went back to college and successfully completed her degree. She received a Bachelor of Science in Communication from Sacramento State University. She worked so hard for that degree, and I tell you, she was very proud. It was such a major accomplishment. I mean, it was no small feat, and honestly, I don't know how she did it. I mean, in her early years, CPCA held a very challenging and demanding position at CPCA. I mean, let's face it, she was working for a young upstart CEO with something to prove. Carole was working under tremendous pressure, and it was usually at the height of my stress and during overwhelming moments that Carole really shone. I mean, it's this motherly quality of Carole that would come out, it would come to the forefront. Because one thing I realized early on is that I might be having a crisis, and in the early years, they were pretty often, but Carole never did. She approached every stressful situation with a smile. She responded to every request and every demand with that smile, and she'd make a note in her notepad, and she'd look at me and she'd say, okay, no problem. She never came to me with a complaint. In all the years she worked for me, she never told me that there was something she couldn't do. She was truly phenomenal. And this can-do attitude, let me tell you, it rubbed off and inspired the entire staff of CPCA. She demonstrated a work ethic that was beyond exemplary. She had a special relationship with each and every staff member, and she functioned as CPCA's matriarch. She was provided a sense of stability and consistency for the organization, and she really carried out her work with an incredible sense of professionalism that we all admired. And her relationship with everyone she worked with, the staff and the membership alike, was really unparalleled. She was exceptional at everything she did. And she was so much more than my executive assistant. And believe me, other departments tried to steal her and make her go work for them. But no, she stayed with me. But her skills were really varied. She was responsible for creating the CPCA Access newsletter, which we still publish on a quarterly basis. She wrote that thing. She edited it for years. She was instrumental in the first annual report. She wrote it, she developed it, she coordinated it for years. Throughout her time with the organization, she was our historian. She documented and captured our history. She archived key documents. I don't know what we would have done if it wasn't for Carole and saving everything, which she did. She was the main liaison to the board of directors, and she spent a good amount of her time taking care of the board's needs and the board chair's needs. She wrote speeches and grant proposals. And on two occasions when we had moves during my tenure, I would leave for a trip, and I would return to my new office, completely moved in, beautiful, all set. I mean, Carole really took care of us. And I'm never going to forget this one time, early in my day, so it's early in the days of MapQuest, where I was driving at the outskirts of UCLA in a complete panic because I was lost. And I was desperate to get to my location for a very important presentation somewhere in that University campus and on time. I didn't know what to do, so I called Carole in a panic. What could she do for me? Well, you'd think nothing. But somehow, in the course of this conversation, Carole calmed me down, helped me get reoriented, and before I knew it, I was back on track to get to my location. And I got to my speech on time. And I tell you, after that, I told my mom, I said, Carole is so amazing. I think she knows magic. I mean, I don't know how she pulled that off. I never forgot how she got me out of that jam. I don't know how she did it, but that was Carole. She really was a miracle worker. And another thing we love about Carole at CPCA is she was game. I mean, she knew how to have a good time. Whether it was dressing up for Halloween or participating in the silly office games that we play there at parties, she was always up and ready to participate. And all the expectant mothers during her tenure at CPCA received a beautiful hand-sewn baby towel for their new babies, and it's something they really treasured from Carole with love. And she is truly an unsung hero, and today we want to honor her hard work, her many contributions, her tireless dedication to really making CPCA the strong organization that it is today. The dictionary defines a hero as a person who, in the opinion of others, has heroic qualities or has performed a heroic act and is regarded as a model or ideal. That is what Carole Loeb was to so many of us at CPCA. She was the model. She was the ideal. She was a caring mentor to many of us, a mother figure to some of us, and she was a friend to all of us. I have given out this award to many people during my 17 years as CEO, and I can't think of a recipient that has impacted my life in a more significant way, or one who has personally touched so many of the lives here in this room as Carole Loeb. So please join me in watching a video tribute for Carole that the CPCA staff put together with love.
Staring out into the night, trying to hide the pain. Different kind of pain. Another
please join me in welcoming Carole's son, Christopher Loeb, to accept this award. Christopher is joined by his wife. This Hero Award to Carole Loeb, and this is for her dedication and outstanding contributions to CPCA's success.
I'd like to say thank you. Everything that was said about her was how she was at home, too. We had any issues, she was the person we called, and she calmed us down and pointed us in the right direction. I know she loved what she did. I know she loved her window, office, the fire department was next door, and she enjoyed when they did their training. That was the number one thing she talked about at work. But on behalf of my whole family, thank you. I know she was loved, it still is, and we miss her.
Thank you for putting this together. Some of us, our family, this is the first time we've actually been able to celebrate a little bit of her passing. So I wanted to thank whomever it was that put this together. We needed this. And also, if she was here, I swear she'd have the waterproof mascara. So she did touch us all. She was a very dynamic woman. So thank you once again for having this for us.
So, actually, as I was walking over here today, I was thinking about the character of the people who work at CPCA, and Carole definitely was somebody who exemplified that those qualities of hard work and commitment and fun. She really liked to have fun, as was we saw in this, the slides that the staff put together. So she was an amazing woman. I lost the rest of my speech. Kirsten, where are you? Okay. I really did. Here, I found it. Got mixed up with Carmelis. So as you can see, our luncheon is ending early today, so we would like to encourage you all to take this gift of time and spend it with our exhibitors down in the trade show hall. Without these loyal supporters, our conference would not be a reality. And as we conclude our luncheon program, we want to remind you again that the CPCA staff is here and ready to assist you with whatever you might need throughout the conference. And as a reminder, the conference is paperless, so all conference materials are available on the CPCA website. And if you need help accessing these, please ask a CPCA staff member. Our afternoon breakout sessions will begin at 2:15. Please follow your program, head for the session of your choice, and we'll gather again this evening at the reception in Exhibit Hall B. And for those of you who are going to tonight's 20th anniversary dinner and soiree, I look forward to seeing you all there, and thank you for being here.